Old Trafford Neighbourhood Management wanted to leave a lasting legacy by investing in the development of leaders living and working in Old Trafford to help contribute to making Old Trafford the place where we love to live, grow, play and prosper. Potent 6, with its Inspiring Leaders programme, was commissioned to support this intention.
The challenges and issues facing our communities cannot be solved by organisations and institutions, certainly not alone. Really, it's the people who live and work in an area who have the greatest power and potential to make a difference. And the Inspiring Leaders programme is actually about bringing together people inside those organisations and people in communities to face those challenges and issues together. What we've done is set up a process where we actually recruit people who have a declared sense of passion and purpose, people who really, really want to make a difference.
These people have shown they are willing to expose themselves to new situations to grow their leadership capacity alongside others whom they may not normally meet.
Okay, my hopes and expectations at the start of the programme were probably, I guess, like a lot of people, not quite sure what was going to happen. It was just the way that it was sold to me made me think, yeah, I could do that. I could improve myself. And I always did have some self-confidence, but didn't always show it. And I think that was part of me thinking, yeah, I can, if I work on it using this leadership programme, then I'll be a better person.
Personally, I have changed in that one of the objectives that I had was that I wanted to increase my learning skills in listening. I wanted to make sure that I actually listened first and then I responded.
Initially, I was like, what is this going to be about? Another something again that's not even going to last 2 minutes. It's going to be just pure rubbish. And I thought, well, I'll go and I'll see. Got to the interview and I thought, okay. Looked at the question, looked at the paper, and I thought, sick and tired of filling in papers, but I will fill it in. It's something for the community. Let me see what they're going to give this time. Let me see if there's going to be different people, because I was so fed up with the same people coming to the same table that I thought, I'm not really interested, but I'm going to, something said to me, go. So I thought, I'm going to go with my gut into it, I'm going to go. And I went, and I thought, yeah. Listened to what they were saying, talked about the projects, and how you can make a difference in your community. And I thought, can I really make a difference in my community? What can they give me to make a difference that I haven't already got? This is me thinking big-headed. And then I realised I didn't have anything. I had it, but I didn't know that I had it.
When I came on the course itself, it was just said it was an Inspiring Leaders course, and they're going to be dealing with certain issues like personal masteries and relationship building and delivery and so forth. So when I went into it, I actually went into it with an open mind, thinking, what is this? Let me try it. And I went in.
I came on the leadership course because I'd been told about it at a meeting I'd been at. I was very, very cynical about it and never thought of going on it at all. Anyway, I thought I'd be open-minded. I don't want to sort of put my cynicism onto other people. And by coincidence, a few days, the following few days, various people came who lived in Old Trafford. I was telling them about this course, seeing if they would be interested. And a lot of people thought it was really, really interesting. And they weren't as cynical as me. And I began thinking, well, perhaps I was wrong.
The Inspiring Leaders programme focuses on three elements: how people manage themselves and their emotions, how they build, maintain and repair relationships, and how they focus on making things happen.
In the workshops, we uncovered a lot of our own personal things. I certainly uncovered some personal fears of mine that I'd hidden for years and years. I'm not saying those feelings had held me back in any way, but they'd certainly... there were sad feelings about death, and so just to explore them and actually to find out that other people in the groups also had similar things was, that was reassuring, that you're not on your own, because I think really that can damage you if you don't get things like that into the open.
after you see everybody actually expressing themselves and talking personally about things in their life, it makes you realise and you just start becoming more and more, I won't say open, just more and more, a little bit more trusting to explain things that are most probably locked away in your head or in your heart, and you're just explaining them and let them out. And because of the confidentiality, it worked a lot better. Confidentiality is very, very, it is a key part of the whole course.
And a lot of things happened in that time as well, going through the workshops, which was sometimes tearful, and sometimes disheartening, and sometimes you felt really angry or frustrated because you wanted to talk on behalf of other people because you thought, oh, I can't see something. And then I thought to myself, I kept bringing myself back. Every situation I was in, I had to keep pulling myself back all the time because there was times when I wanted to just jump out and say things, and I thought, Dre, shut up, it's not about you. Everybody's got to grow, we're all at different levels. And that's when I realised not everybody sees the same thing.
Well, we were given a sort of metaphor about geese. This made me very aware there is a leading geese, but then when that geese gets a bit tired, one of the other geese will take its place, and you get, say, seven together, one in the middle. And then the one in the middle will suddenly go to the back, and the one who was in the second row will go on to the leader. And that's really what the metaphor is all about.
And our lesson is that those who share a common direction and sense of community get where they are going quicker and easier because they're travelling on the thrust of one another.
In order to make real change in this community, people have gone through deep internal personal change. This has involved them confronting and overcoming personal fears, reframing limiting beliefs or fictions about themselves that have kept them holding back from doing things they're truly capable of. There have been moments of truth-telling and revelation that have created sudden transformations in people's behaviour and understanding. What has been witnessed is a huge shift in the inspiring leaders, with a promise of much, much more to come in and for Old Trafford.
Oh, well, when we attended the workshop, one of the first things that was pointed out to us was the facts, feelings and fictions. I certainly realised anyway that this is why there's a lot of problems in the world. People act without knowing the facts. They make fictions up, and the feelings are based on the fictions rather than the facts.
Using tools like facts, fiction and feelings, people are enabled to connect with their feelings and to use them as a source of creative energy and power rather than as uncontrollable destructive forces. The coaching deepens people's learning and enables them to develop their emotional resilience and resourcefulness.
It's got a value to it. It allows you to either confirm that you're going the right direction, you're doing the right things, or, whoa, stop, you're going a little bit down the wrong path. You should actually be doing this. And so grateful to Louie for those coaching sessions, and I think everybody will be, because that's the stage you find out whether you're progressing or not.
It's really made me analyse more before reacting. Makes me get along with people a lot easier. I can understand people who need to talk to me and who just want to talk for talk. I come across a lot of people that need to talk, and it does drain you a lot, but I don't know, beforehand I never really realised it. Now I realise what it is, it feels a lot more empowering to myself, to know that I know myself more.
Each inspiring leader was required to identify a project that would help deliver the vision of Old Trafford. Collectively, they have come up with an incredible range of ideas. A domestic violence project, a history trail, a cross-generational fitness programme.
Well, my project, I've got two projects, but the main one that I'm going to be trying to put off at the moment is the health one. I'm looking at health and fitness. I'm trying to get into schools with workshops, getting people from the community and families as well. I've already been given an okay to use the Sharon Church Youth Centre. I'm looking to get some funding, to get some apparatus as well. Fitness first, so that they'll probably help me out with a few bikes and things. So hopefully when I get myself sorted with that, I'll be able to do these workshops and take them around the place. And I want you to go into schools as well, looking at health and fitness and healthy eating.
Our new project, which we are working with police, that's going very well. And police, every Tuesday, they come over there, you know, at Edison House. We gave them four volunteers. One is a female and three females. And they will go and do the volunteer work with police.
It's called Saturday Nights, and the idea is to help people who want to start voluntary work but perhaps haven't got the confidence to just walk into a new place or a new environment, or people not work for a while, people might have mental health problems, lack of confidence, or just ordinary people.
A really important part of these projects was getting the inspiring leaders to enrol new volunteers to help them in the delivery.
So I'm looking for more volunteers to help other volunteers, and it's known as supported volunteering.
Each inspiring leader's power is emerging and blossoming in different ways, at different paces, and at different stages in the inspiring leader's process.
I decided that I would embark on the Inspiring Leadership Programme to put a project together where I could provide a mediation and training programme for all those that are involved in gun life and gang culture, not just the young people, but also the families, the close family friends, communities, and even agencies that work in it.
I'm going to do a history trail of Old Trafford. I'm going to build on what's already here, which is the local history that's already here, like L.S. Lowry and Dame Isabel Bailey and the person who wrote 1001 Dalmatians. But I'm going to also build into it the improvements that we've made into the parks and gardens. By the end of it, we're hoping to have a map that you would find in any town that you went to visit.
Yes, my project is to do with social media and telling us a story about what's happening within Old Trafford. It literally is as simple as tell us what you want to tell us. The idea is that we communicate with our neighbours. We communicate with people within Old Trafford and tell everyone what's going on. It's a way of conveying certain things that might not be quite so exciting or quite so happy. And to visit the blog, all you need to do is go to www.whatshappeningot.wordpress.com.
What has been so inspiring for me is seeing and hearing about the changes that this programme is making for individuals. And some of these may not seem very big to an outsider, but what they represent is, in many instances, a profound internal shift and a profound change of engagement and self-belief that I think will bring benefits to this area for many years to come.
One woman referred to me by somewhere a couple of years ago, and she had no confidence at all. Her eyes were always averted. She wouldn't look up at anybody and didn't talk much. Anyway, I took her a few times to this particular group, and the difference in her now, and she's got a job interview shortly, and the difference in her, she's so confident. And one day when there weren't enough people sort of to help, I said, oh, you're in charge now. And she got everything out, sorted it out, and you wouldn't, if you didn't know that she hadn't had any confidence before, you'd just never guess.
Not everybody sees the same thing. Even if you have a vision and you give it to somebody and they look, their vision of it is completely different to yours. So you have to take them through step by step to understand your vision. You have to show them the process and the this. And that's what the course did. It showed you the process of developing as a leader and how to lead and develop others as well. I needed to channel my energies in a different way in order to help others, because it wasn't even though it was helping in some respects, it wasn't long term. For me, it was quite short lived and quite sort of like it'd go and then it'd stop and then it'd veer off somewhere else. Now, from doing this course, I'm more focused and directed where I'm going.
One of the elements of being on the course is that you can then train and become a trainer in self-esteem enhancement. And so what I've done is I've been in discussions, and we're going to try and train up the parents from the parenting programme so that then they can then go out there and either just keep the self-esteem enhancement training for themselves to better themselves, or they've got the choice of actually becoming trainers and then training it to others.
This leadership programme has helped me to boost that, really. We all flag at times, but also we can also be boosted. You know, each day is a new day. So to me, it's given me more self-confidence. It makes me think in a different way. And generally, I think you can live life and feel better about yourself if you do all those things.
I've been doing a lot more work in the community and other communities now, like with drug and awareness programmes up in Partington. And they've just had some funding, so they're putting a whole new studio in there and all sorts. I'm going to be going there to teach them.
One of the other things that I've found about the Inspiring Leadership Development Programme is that I've been able to sort of, you know, as many people know, I work with young people. I've been able to sort of share those skills with the young people. So hopefully that we will have a group of young people that in the future will be the inspiring leaders of Old Trafford.
This is just the beginning of a marvellous legacy for the people of Old Trafford and is a testament to the vision of the Old Trafford Neighbourhood Management Partnership to make Old Trafford the place where people love to live, grow, play and prosper.